Hello everybody.
Today we are going to discuss the mathematical expectation for a in case of joint probability distribution. For example, over here we are considering two random variables, capital X and capital Y. So we have a joint probability distribution of the bivariate random variable X, Y, and we are going to define the expectation of a expectation in case of a bivariate distribution. Expectation of what? Expectation of a function of these two random variables X and Y. So if in terms of real variable, if suppose g is a function, small g is a function of X and Y, then in terms of this corresponding random variables capital X and capital Y, this should be the expression. Remember, we are not writing the function capital G over there. We are not changing the function capital G. We are not changing the function small g into capital G, because it may have it may so happen that small g refers to the sine function and capital G refers to the cosine function. Okay, so over here remember that we are not changing this function g at all. That's why this functional expression g, it's not changing at all. Just in place of small x and small y, in place of these two real variables, we are putting these two random variables capital X and capital Y. Alright, so over here we are going to define the expectation or mean value of this continuous function g of X, Y. Remember, over here we are taking this function g as a continuous function. So in case of discrete two-dimensional distribution, the expectation of the function g of X, Y, this expectation is defined in this fashion. Summation, summation is taken over in the indices I and j. Over here, by definition, you can take any order. That means at least at first you can take the summation over j and then the summation over I, or in opposite order. So it can also be a summation over I, and then we can take a summation over j, it doesn't matter. Anyway, so in summation over I and j, theoretically I and j are varying from minus infinity to infinity, g of xi comma yj. Remember, over here xi and yj, xi yj, these two, these are actually the elements of the spectrum of the two-dimensional random variable x comma y. Okay, so g of xi comma yj multiplied by the corresponding probability mass function fij. And in case of continuous distribution, we are defining this expectation in the fashion that summation, in place of summation we are considering integration. Okay, integration one is taken over the random variable x or corresponding real variable small x, and second one is taken over the another variable y. So g of x comma y multiplied by the corresponding probability density function f of x comma y dx dy. And remember, over here this infinite series or this infinite integral, both of these two, infinite series and infinite integral, must be absolutely convergent. If the corresponding infinite series of this infinite integral, these two are not absolutely convergent, in that case we say that the expectation does not exist. So in order to define the expectation, we must have this infinite sum or this infinite integral, both of these two, infinite integral and infinite sum, must be absolutely convergent. Now let's discuss some results over here. For considering the particular case over here, if particularly over here in place of this function of two variables g of x comma y, if suppose we have a function of single variable x only, if suppose we have a function of single variable x only, then what happens? We have, if we apply in the same definition over here, you see in case of discrete distribution, we are going to put this result. The similar two holds in case for continuous distribution as well. Anyway, so expectation of gx by this definition, expectation of gx. What would be the expectation of gx? So we shall have summation over I and then summation over j multiplied by, as because we have a function of single variable x only, so we shall have g of xi multiplied by the corresponding probability mass function fij. And you see, this expression g of xi, this expression does not depend upon the index j. Therefore, we can take this expression outside this inner summation, and we can write it as summation over I g of xi multiplied by summation over j fij. Now what is this? This expression is nothing but is equal to the marginal mass function of if marginal mass function of what? Of the marginal distribution of x, because you see this is actually summation over j. So if we take the summation over the second index j, then we shall get the marginal distribution of the random variable x, that which is actually in the corresponding mass function is actually written as fi dot. So over here we write it as fi dot, and therefore if you consider this one, you will find that you can also write this fi dot as equal to fxi. It doesn't matter, you can use any one expression. But what is this? This is actually the expression of the expectation of gx obtained from the marginal distribution of x. Okay, so what we observe over here is that if we have a function of single variable, you can obtain the expression of such a function from this definition of expectation from the joint distribution, and that expectation, that value would ultimately be equal to the expression of the expectation obtained from the marginal distribution. So similar result can be proved in case of continuous distribution as well. You observe that this is the formula obtained from the joint distribution of the random variables x and y. And ultimately, by computation, what you observe that this expression is actually the expression obtained from the marginal distribution of x. So, expression of the expectation of g of x obtained from the marginal distribution of x. So, if we have a function of single variable, you can without any hesitation, you can simply apply this kind of formula, or you can compute the expectation of the function from the marginal distribution of the corresponding random variable. This result can also be improved if you consider the any function of y. So if you want to compute expectation of g of y, you can without any hesitation, you can directly compute this expression from the marginal distribution of y. Okay. Now let's discuss an example over here. You see, if we have only this kind of function, expectation of x plus y, and you see in case of expectation, we defined this expectation as either as integral or as this kind of infinite summation. So both of these two operations, integration operation and this summation operation, both of these two operations are actually linear transformations. And that's why this kind of results that become always true, that means expectation of g1 of x comma y plus g2 of x comma y etc plus plus gn of x comma y, that becomes equal to the sum of all the expectation of the individual functions, expectation of g1 plus expectation of g2 class expectation of G3 and so on. So particularly if we consider this expression, expectation of x plus y, we can write it as expectation of x plus expectation of y. So this is actually a direct result obtained from the definition of the expectation. Now let's consider an example over here. We considered this example earlier. Let me open that example over here. Let me go back to this section number, example 1, section number 6.2. You can recall this example that we discussed in the previous lectures. I'm not going to detail, going to discuss in detail. Over here, we can see that this is the spectrum. And in this spectrum, we have 9 points. These are the 9 points. And these are the points for j is equal to 0, 1, 2, and 3, and for I is equal to 0. Next, for I is equal to 1, we have j is equal to 0, then j is equal to 1, and then j is equal to 2. And then from I is equal to 2, this I is equal to 2 line, and we have j is equal to 0 and j is equal to 1. So this is the line I is equal to 0, this is the line I is equal to 1, this is the line I is equal to 2. So for I is equal to 1, we have j is equal to 0, j is equal to 1, j is equal to 2, and j is equal to 3, and so on. So in this fashion, we actually have 9 points in the spectrum, and the probability if ij, the probability mass function if ij is equal to 1 by 9 in these functions. And at these points, we actually do not have any probability mass function. So at this point, the probability mass function is equal to 0. So we can say that if ij, this if ij is equal to 1 by 9, when except at this point, this point, and this point. All right. So except at this point, what is this point? This point is actually the 2, 2 point. This is the point 2, 3 point, and this is actually the point 1, 2. So other than these 3 points, we can say that this expectation, this value of the this density function is equal to 1 by 9. Sorry, not density function, the mass function. The value of this mass function is equal to 1 by 9. Now, at this point, if we want to compute the value of this expectation of modulus of x minus y. All right, so we are going to compute this result. So let me go back to that page. Okay, so this was the result. You see that except at this point 1, 3, 2, 2, and 2, 3, this value of the probability mass function is equal to 1 by 9. Okay. Now over here, you can check that summation, this would be minus, appending mistake is there, modulus of x minus y. So expectation of this modulus of x minus y, that it is equal to, what you observe is that j is varying from 0, 1, 2, 3, and I is varying from 0, 1, and 2. Therefore, we have taken this summation, j is equal to 0 to 3, and I is equal to 0 to 2. Although in the definition, I and j are supposed to vary from minus infinity to infinity, but in this particular case, when j is varying from 0 to 3 and I is varying from 0 to 2, therefore we are taking this summation j is equal to 0 to 3, and summation over I is equal to 1 to I is equal to 0 to 2. All right. And in place of x minus y, what are the values of x and y? The values of x are equal to I, and values of y, these are represented by j. All right. So in place of x, we are putting I, and in place of y, we are putting j. Therefore, what we have in place of x minus y, in place of modulus of x minus y, we shall have modulus of I minus j multiplied by this probability mass function Fij. And then just we expand this result and we just put in place of F13, F22, and A23, you just put this functional, this probability mass function is equal to 0, and other one is except at this 3 points, you put Fij is equal to 1/9. So if we expand them, and ultimately by mathematical algebraic calculation, we get this result is equal to 11/9. So in this way, we can compute these values of more expectation of x minus 1. Okay. So these are the result that we obtained from this example in this section 6.2. What is moment? We can say that moment is actually there are many moments, but over here we shall mainly try to define the moment that is called raw moments and central moments. Raw moments and another kind of moment that we shall discuss over here is central moment. So what is raw moment and central moment? Over here you see AEL. This it appears that it is AKL, but in some book in fact it is sometimes also represented as alpha in place of A. So without any loss of generality, we shall designate this as alpha. All right. So what we defined AKL or alpha KL. Alpha KL is actually expectation of x to the power of k into y to the power of l, where a and l, these are non-negative integers. They should be either equal to 0 or positive integers. They would never be negative integer. And this alpha kl, this alpha kl or a suffix kl, whatever you call, this alpha kl is called a moment of order k plus l. Therefore, if we simply write this kind of expression where L is equal to 0, if we put L is equal to 0, then what we have? Then we have alpha A 0. And that would be nothing but is equal to expectation of x to the power of k. All right. And that is nothing but is equal to the expectation obtained from the marginal distribution, the expectation of kth order expectation obtained from marginal distribution. That's why we can write it as alpha x suffix k. So marginal distribution, the kth order marginal distribution obtained from the marginal distribution of x. Similarly, we can also put k is equal to 0. In that case, we shall have alpha 0 L, and that would be is equal to expectation of y to the power of L, and that is equal to the expectation obtained from the marginal distribution, obtained from the marginal distribution, and that is nothing but is equal to the moment of order K. So you can write it alpha y L. So we have this type of relation. Particularly, if you consider k is equal to 0 and l is equal to 0, then you can think that alpha 0 0 is equal to 1. Alpha 1 0, what is alpha 1 0? Alpha 1 0, that is equal to expectation of x only. So we can write it as the mean of x. Similarly, alpha 0 1, that is equal to expectation of y, that would be is equal to mean of y. So in this way, we can define the moment of order of different orders, and there alpha 1 0 is equal to the mean of x, and alpha 2 0 is equal to the mean of y. So we have this particular cases regarding the moments. Now we define the central moments. What are central moments? Central moments are defined about the corresponding mean and mean of x and mean of y. So over here, in place of x, in the definition of raw moment, we just writing in place of x, we are writing x minus mx, and in place of y, we are writing y minus my. So we have over here the central moment, and this is represented by mu suffix k comma k comma l, or you can simply write kl. So mu k is equal to expectation of x minus mx to the power of k multiplied by y minus my to the power of l. So over here k and l both are integers greater than or is equal to 0. They are non-negative integers. Particularly if we suppose over here say l is equal to 0, you suppose l is equal to 0, then you see this term would not appear. We shall simply have expectation of x minus mx to the power of k, and in that case we can simply write mu k 0, that is equal to expectation of what, x minus mx to the power of k, and that would be is equal to the kth order central moment obtained from the marginal distribution. So we can write mu x k in this way, mu x k. So kth order central moment obtained from the marginal distribution of x. So we can write it as mu x k. Similarly, if we put l not equal to 0 but k is equal to 0, in that case also we can have a similar result, like mu 0 l is equal to the lth central moment obtained from the marginal distribution. So we can write mu 0 l is equal to mu y l. So that this kind of result holds. And particularly if we put over here k is equal to 0 and l is equal to 0, we shall have mu 0 0 is equal to 1. You can check that mu 1 0 is equal to 0. Let me just show you this result. What is mu 1 0? Mu 1 0, that is actually is equal to expectation of k is equal to 1 and l is equal to 0. So we shall have simply expectation of x minus mx. And what is this? Expectation of x minus expectation of this mx, and expectation of x is equal to the mean of x, and expectation of a constant, this is a constant quantity mx, so expectation of this constant is equal to the quantity mx itself, therefore this expectation becomes is equal to 0. So that's why we have mu of 1 comma 0 is equal to 0. So you can also check this result that mu of 0 comma 1 is also is equal to 0. Secondly, if you put l is equal to 0 and k is equal to 1, then what we have, we shall have mu 2 comma 0, k is equal to 2 and l is equal to 0, and in that case we shall have this type of expression x minus mx whole square, expectation of x minus mx whole square. And what is this? This is the this is actually the variance of x, therefore we can write this expression as sigma x square. So similarly we can write mu 0 comma 2 is equal to sigma y, that is the variance of y, sigma y square. All right, so in this way we can easily for different reasons. Now particularly if we consider mu 1 1, what we have, this mu 1 1 is particularly called the covariance. Covariance, we write it in this way, covariance of x comma y. Now in that case, what would be the expression of covariance? We are going to show this result over here. So mu 1 1, that is actually the covariance of x comma y, is equal to this expectation of x minus this expectation of x minus mx into y minus my. So this is the expression of covariance. And what is the utility of this covariance? We are showing this result one by one. Suppose we have a random variable like capital X, and this random variable capital X has the mean mx and standard deviation sigma x. In that case, we write x star. X star, we define it in this way. Say x minus mx divided by sigma x. What is this? This is actually the standardized variate corresponding to x. Then what is the expectation of this variable x star? Expectation of x star is equal to, you see, expectation of this x minus mx divided by sigma x. Alright. And that can be written as, you see, this sigma x is actually a number, pure number. So we can write it as 1 by sigma x. And what we have is we have expectation of x minus mx. Just by similar technique, shown in this lecture earlier, we can simply write it as 1 by sigma x, and then we can write it expectation of x minus expectation of this quantity mx, and then this is equal to 1 by sigma x. So this expression is equal to mx, and expectation of mx that is also is equal to mx, and therefore this value is equal to 0. So what we have, that expectation of this kind of standardized variate is always equal to 0. Similarly, if we can define the standardized variate corresponding to y, then we can write y minus my divided by sigma y, and we shall have expectation of this y star, this expectation is equal to 0. So please remember that expectation of standardized variates are always equal to 0. Expectation of standardized variates are always equal to 0. Now, particularly if we can define one result that is actually called the correlation coefficient. What is this? Correlation coefficient is actually the covariance of x star and y star. Correlation coefficient is actually the covariance of x star and y star. So you see, this covariance, this expression, this expression, what would be the expression of covariance of x star and y star? You see, this is actually the definition of covariance. So if we write x star and y star over here, then we shall have x star and we shall have y star, and this is actually the mean star. Mx star means the mean of the standardized variate, and this is the mean of the standardized variate y. But we already have proved, just recently we have proved, that mean of this kind of standardized variate, this is equal to 0. Similarly, the mean of this standardized variate of y, that is also equal to 0. So these terms becomes equal to 0. This term and this term, mx and my become is equal to 0. So we actually have expectation of simply x star multiplied by y star. So this would be the expression of the covariance. That's why you can see that over here we have this result, that covariance of x star y star is equal to expectation of x star and y star. Now, if we put the expressions of x star and y star is equal to x minus mx divided by sigma x, and y minus my divided by sigma y is actually the expression of this y star, and this x, sigma y, these are actually constant, so we can take it outside this expectation. And ultimately, what we observe is that over here, the numerator, this numerator expression, is equal to the covariance of x, y. And this row, this covariance of x, y divided by sigma x and sigma y, provided of course sigma x and sigma y are both are not equal to 0. So what we have, we actually have this result. This is called the correlation coefficient in between x and y. So we actually have this result. But still, the question remains that what is the utility of covariance of x, y, or in other words, what is the utility of this correlation coefficient. Let me show you the utility by few results through the discussion of the results. Over here, we are first going to show that if capital X and capital Y are independent random variables, okay, if capital X and capital Y are independent random variables, in that case, this correlation coefficient or this covariance becomes is equal to 0. So we are going to show that if capital X and capital Y are independent random variables, in that case, this covariance or this correlation coefficient become equal to 0. Okay. So how to prove this result? Let us suppose that a capital X and capital Y are independent variables. In that case, you can check that covariance of X comma Y. Covariance of X comma Y is actually the definition of covariance of X comma Y. And in case of continuous distribution, I am proving this result. In case of discrete distribution as well, you can similarly prove this result. So as because this capital X and capital Y are independent random variables, therefore this is actually the expression of this total expectation. This is the expression of this total expectation. Expectation of X minus MX multiplied by Y minus MY. Now you see, as because capital X and capital Y are independent variables, therefore this joint density function, this joint density function can be written as the product of marginal density function of X and marginal density function of Y. Okay. Therefore, this marginal density function of X and marginal density function of Y is a purely function of X and purely a function of Y. This is purely a function of Y. So this density function of X can be combined with this expression of X minus MX, and this density function of Y can be combined with this function Y minus MY. So this total integrand can be written as the product of this function. This is actually purely function of X, and the product of this function is actually the actually purely a function of Y. And that's why we can separate this double integral into the product of two integral. This is a product or this is a product of two integral. This is the integral over X and this integral over Y. And you can check that this expression is actually the expectation of X minus MX, which becomes is equal to 0 as I proved earlier. And this is actually expectation of Y minus Y, MY, Y minus MY, which is also equal to 0. Therefore, altogether, we can say that this becomes is equal to 0, provided capital X and capital Y are independent variables. Thus, we observe that covariance of X comma Y becomes is equal to 0 in case of independent random variables. Okay, and similarly, we can say that this expression, this row correlation coefficient, could also be equal to 0 in case of independent random variables. But the converse result, that if rho is equal to 0, and does this imply that X and Y are independent of each other? Answer is no. We shall prove this result, but before the proof of this result, let us prove two other theorems as well over here. First of all, I am going to show that if U is actually a linear combination or a linear transformation of X, and V is a linear transformation of Y, where of course A1 and A2 is not, both of them are not equal to 0. In that case, we can prove that correlation coefficient in between E and V, that is equal to this kind of expression, A1 A2 divided by modulus of A1 and A2 modulus of A2 multiplied by the correlation coefficient in between X and Y. How to prove this result? You see, we have this type of transformation. And if we consider the expectation on both sides of this relation and the expectation on both sides of this relation, then we should have this type of result. Expectation of U is equal to A1 into expectation of X plus B1. Similarly, expectation of V is equal to A2 into expectation of Y plus B2. And this, what is expectation of U? That is actually the mean of U. And what is expectation of X? This is actually mean of X. So we can write mu is equal to a1 into mx plus b1. So you observe that in terms of the expectation or in terms of the mean value, this result is exactly similar to the relationship between the original random variables x and u. So similarly, as because v is related to this random variable y by this kind of linear transformation, you remember this result would be true only in case of linear transformation. So over here we have a linear transformation from y to v. Therefore, we can simply directly write that m of v is equal to a to my plus b. Now, what is u minus my? You see u minus my, if you compute u minus my, consider these expressions, you will find that this b1 will get cancelled and you shall have a1x minus a1 into mx. So we can write it as a1 into x minus mx. Therefore, expectation of y minus my is equal to a1 into expectation of x minus mx. Or you can simply write it in this way, that this implies that you can write it over here, that this one, expectation of x minus m whole square, that would be is equal to a1 square into x minus mx whole square, and then take the expectation. So we shall have u minus m whole square is equal to a1 square into expectation of x minus mx whole square. So this result is actually the standard, this is actually the variance of u. So we can write it as sigma u whole square, and this is actually the variance of x. So we can write it as sigma x whole square, and we have a1 square. So if we now consider this a1 square is equal to modulus of a1 whole square. So now taking the positive square root from this result, we can say that sigma u is equal to a1 modulus of a1 into sigma x. All right. Similarly, we can write sigma v is equal to modulus of a2 into sigma y. Now, what is u minus mu multiplied by v minus mv? Remember, we have to find out the coefficient in between u and v. That's why we need to firstly compute the covariance in between u and v. So we are going to firstly compute the covariance in between u and v. That's why we need this expression u minus mx multiplied by v minus my. We already have the expression of u minus mx is equal to a1 into x minus my. Similarly, we can have the expression of v minus my, that would be is equal to a2 multiplied by this expression y minus my. So we have this relation, taking expectation on both sides, we can write a1, a2 multiplied by expectation of this x minus mx, x minus mx into y minus m. So over here, and the covariance of u, we can be written as a1 into the covariance of x from over. Now, what is the correlation coefficient rho in between u and v? That is equal to covariance of u divided by sigma u and sigma v. So we already computed the expression of covariance of u is equal to this type of a1, a2, covariance of x, y. So we have this relation. Again, we have computed this sigma u and sigma v. So if we put them over here, we get this type of relation. And this can be separated as covariance of x, y divided by sigma x, sigma, that is actually equal to this rho of x, y, and the remaining term u. So we put this, we already put this result. Next result that we are going to put is that if y is a linear combination of x, y is a linear combination of x, if and only if rho of x, y is equal to plus minus 1. What we observe is that we firstly consider that rho of x, y is equal to plus minus 1, and we shall prove that y is a function of x. If rho of x comma y is equal to plus minus 1, then rho of x comma y is equal to actually the covariance of x star y star. Already in this definition, you already got this definition that rho of x comma y is equal to the covariance of x star y star, this type of relation. Okay, so we are using this result. The covariance of x star y star, what is this? Covariance of x star y star is equal to expectation of x star into y star. So we put the expectation of x star into y star. Therefore, if expectation of x star y star is equal to plus minus 1, consider this one, and for this plus sign, we take the minus symbol, And for this minus sign over here, we take the plus symbol. That's why we are taking this expectation of x star minus plus y star whole square. That can be written as expectation of x star square plus expectation of y star square minus plus 2 into expectation of x star y star, and this is equal to plus minus 1. Hmm? So if we have plus symbol over here, in that case over here we shall consider the minus symbol. If we have minus symbol over here, then we can write plus symbol. And we it can be proved that expectation of this kind of x star square, that is equal to what is this? This is equal to plus 1, and this is equal to plus 1. We are going to prove that what is the value of expectation of x star square. Alright, so let me show this result. Expectation of x star square means, what is x star? X star is equal to x minus mx divided by sigma, so square of this quantity. And this can be written as expectation of, in the numerator we shall have x minus mx whole square divided by sigma x square, and as because this sigma x is actually a constant quantity, we can take it outside this expectation, so we can write it as 1 by sigma x square multiplied by, we have expectation of x minus mx whole square, so this is equal to 1 by sigma x square, and this expression is also is equal to sigma x square, therefore this value is equal to 1. So what we observe over here, that this kind of quantity, expectation of x star is equal to plus 1, similarly expectation of y star is equal to plus 1. So if you put these expressions over here, that will be 1 plus 1 minus plus 2 into plus minus 1. So you can now check that this value will be equal to 0. Okay. This value will be always equal to 0. So expectation of this kind of non-negative quantity is equal to 0 means this non-negative quantity x star minus plus y star whole square is itself equal to 0, or in other words, this is equal to 0, and therefore we can write x star is equal to plus minus y star. This is the expression of x star and this is the expression of y star. So what is this? This is actually a linear relationship in between x and y. So we can say that y is a linear function of x. Therefore, if we suppose that rho of x comma y is equal to plus minus 1, we have proved that y is a linear function of x. And conversely, if we suppose that y is a linear function of x, conversely, if we suppose y is equal to x plus b, you see this type of relationship can be simply converted into the expression that y is equal to x plus b. So if y is equal to x plus b, then we already discussed that this sigma y becomes equal to modulus of a1, modulus of a into sigma x. And similarly, mean of y is equal to a into m of x plus b. And therefore, this y minus my can be written as a into x minus mx. Therefore, covariance of x comma y is equal to expectation of x minus mx, x minus mx multiplied by y minus my. Okay. And therefore, this expression, if you put the expression of y minus my over there, a into x minus mx, in place of y minus my, we just, if you put a into x minus mx, then what we have, you see, in place of this type of expression, if you put in place of x minus my, if you put a into x minus mx, then we have this type of relation, and this a can be taken outside this expectation. and this x minus mx and this x minus mx, they can be combined and multiplied together, can be written as x into expectation of x minus mx whole square. And what is this? This is equal to the standard deviation. This is actually the variance of x. So we can write it as sigma x whole square. Therefore, what is rho of x comma y? Rho of x comma y is equal to covariance of xy divided by sigma x sigma y. That is equal to a into sigma x square. And what is sigma y? You see, this is actually, this numerator is actually the, this numerator covariance of x comma y is actually the a into sigma x whole square. So we put it over here. And what is this sigma y? This sigma y, you have already proved that this sigma y is equal to modulus of a into sigma x. So we write modulus of a into sigma x. So you can check that this sigma x along with this sigma x and this sigma x whole square in the numerator, they get cancelled. In that case, we shall have a divided by modulus of a. So this value is equal to either plus 1 or minus 1, depending whether a is positive or negative. Okay, so we have rho of x comma y is equal to plus minus 1. And we are going to prove this result also, that minus 1 less than is equal to rho less than is equal to plus 1. So over here, we can check that expectation of x minus mx whole square can be written as this one, expectation of x star square plus expectation of y star square. So expectation of x star plus minus y star whole square can be written as expectation of x star whole square, expectation of y star square plus minus 2 into expectation of x star y star. And we have already put that this value is equal to 1, this value is equal to 1, and expectation of x star y star. What is this expectation of x star y star? This expectation of y, x star y star over here, you can check this expectation of x star y star is equal to the correlation coefficient in between x and y. So we can write in place of this expectation of x star y star, we can write the correlation coefficient rho. Just we are writing rho in place of rho of x comma y for the sake of synthesis. This is equal to 1, so we write 1 over here. This is also 1, so we write 1 over here. So what we got? We got the result that if we combine them, we will write it as 2 into 1 plus minus rho, that is greater than is equal to 0. And therefore, we can say that 1 plus minus rho is greater than is equal to 0. And this can be written as minus 1 less than is equal to rho less than 1. Okay. So what you observe that rho, the value of this correlation coefficient can never be greater than 1 and can never be less than minus 1. Okay. And we already proved that in case of independent random variables x and y, the correlation coefficient vanishes. But the question was that is the converse result true? We already proved that in case of independent variables, the correlation coefficient rho becomes is equal to 0. We are going to discuss this result, this example, just for the converse case. The answer to the converse question is that the converse result is not always true. You see, if you consider this type of result, y is equal to x square, and suppose x is a symmetric distribution about the origin, symmetric about the origin. What does it mean, symmetric about the origin? It means that, you see, symmetric about the origin means the density function of x will be symmetric about the origin, okay, and about this step of origin. And due to symmetry, this one about the origin 0, that means due to symmetry, if one can prove that expectation of x is equal to 0. Similarly, any odd order expectation like expectation of x cube or expectation of x to the power of 5, all such odd order distribution, all such odd order expectations would be is equal to 0. Okay, so over here one can prove that expectation of x is equal to 0 and expectation of x cube is also is equal to 0. And therefore, covariance of x comma y, this is the formula for covariance of x comma y, and we prove that this expectation of x is equal to 0 means mean of x is equal to 0. So in place of this mx, we put 0 over here. In place of y, we put this relation x square. So in place of y, we put x square and keep it my as it is. Don't touch this my, don't change the value of my. And now this expression, this expression can be written separately as QC, expectation of x cube minus my into expectation of x. But what is expectation of x cube? That's because x is a symmetric, symmetric distribution. Therefore, expectation of x cube is equal to 0. So we can put that this is equal to 0. Again, this expectation of x, that is also is equal to 0. So altogether, this total value becomes is equal to 0. Therefore, covariance of x, y becomes is equal to 0 in this case. And as long as covariance of x, y is equal to 0, therefore, rho of x, y is equal to 0. However, we see that y is a function of x. Thus, we observe that if y is dependent on x, then it may so happen that the correlation coefficient becomes equal to 0. So, what is the gist that we can say from this discussion so far? We can say that correlation coefficient if p is equal to 0. If correlation coefficient becomes equal to 0, it doesn't mean that capital X and Y are independent. Just we simply say that capital X and Y are linearly independent. That means there is no linear relationship. This is a non-linear relationship. So we simply say that there is no linear relationship in between X and Y. Okay. Now let me complete this lecture by the computation of correlation coefficient in case of bivariate normal distribution. You see, we know that the density function of the bivariate normal distribution can be written as 1 by sigma, 1 by twice pi sigma x sigma y into power of 1 minus o square into e to the power of a very large kind of exponent. E to the power of, I am just writing this exponent as equal to k, e to the power of minus k, where k is equal to this kind of expression 1 by 2, 1 minus rho square into this one. Now you can easily identify that this is actually the standardized variable, standardized expression, standardized expression of x. So x minus mx divided by sigma x, x whole square over here x minus mx divided by sigma x. Then we have y minus my divided by sigma y along with this twice rho. And over here y minus my divided by sigma y whole square. So we write this expression as equal to x star, and this standardized expression of y as equal to y star. In terms of real variable, we have this type of relation. Therefore, this exponent that is actually designated by k over here, this exponent can be written over here in this way, x star square minus 2 y star x star y star plus y star square. And this can be further written this way, x star minus rho into sigma rho into y star whole square plus y star square into 1 minus rho square. Now, we take this type of relationship and consider the transformation. So, if we have this type of transformation, and in that case, d of x star would be equal to 1 by sigma x into dx. Similarly, from this relation, we observe that d of y star would be equal to 1 by sigma y into dy. And the Jacobian of the transformation, Jacobian of x, y with respect to x star, y star becomes equal to sigma x, sigma y. Now you see covariance of x, y. This is actually the formula for covariance of x, y. And over here you can check that this is the integral of this expectation of x minus mx and y minus my. And over here we are just writing this expression of this density function. For simplicity, we are writing this exponent e to the power minus k. Now we apply the transformation and we convert these variables x and y into x star and y star. So if we write x star over here, you see x minus mx. This x minus mx is actually the numerator over here. So this x minus mx is equal to the product of x star into this sigma x. So we have this type of relation sigma x into x star, that is actually is equal to x minus mx. Similarly, y minus my is equal to sigma y into y star, and this dx dy will be equal to this type of Jacobian of x, y with respect to x star y star multiplied by dx star dy star. So we have already have computed the value of this Jacobian. This Jacobian is equal to sigma x, sigma y. Of course, these are positive quantities. You already know that in bivariate normal distribution, sigma x and sigma y are positive quantities. So we can write this expression is equal to simply sigma x, sigma y, and we have dx star, dy star. So over here, you see that this expressions, this sigma x, this sigma y, along with this sigma x and this this sigma y. Over here, they will cancel each other, and finally we have this type of relationship. And you see, by computation, this exponent, we are just putting this expression of this k. We already have computed the expression of this expression k, so we just put it over here. So if you put this expression of k over here, this is the expression of k. Like this, and make the computation, then ultimately what we observe is that this type of expression, x into y into e to the power of this type of expression over here, can be decomposed into this type of term that is equal to integral over y, and this is actually the integral over x. And this m is actually written as rho into y, just for the simplicity of the computation. You see, we have taken m is equal to rho into y, and this sigma has been taken as root over of rho square. So we actually have, after simplification, we actually have this type of expression. And what is this? This is actually the expectation of x. You observe that this quantity is actually the density function of the normal m comma sigma variate. And therefore, we can simply write, if we write x is equal to this kind of expression, that would be equal to expectation of, if for the simplicity, if you call it that there is a sigma, this is a z variate, then you can write it as expectation of z, and that is nothing but is equal to expectation of z is equal to this parameter m. Therefore, we can write m is equal to rho into y, that is actually the value of this integral. Okay. And therefore, if we put the value of this integral, this integral inside the second bracket, so this value is equal to small m. So we put small m or rho of y over here, rho of y into dy, and then we again perform the integration. And by simplification, what we observe is that we ultimately get this relation rho into sigma x, sigma y. Okay. And therefore, covariance means what we got, but covariance of x comma y is equal to 2 into sigma x into sigma y. So what is the correlation coefficient in between rho, correlation coefficient in between x comma y? Correlation coefficient has this type of formula, rho sigma covariance of x comma y divided by sigma x sigma y. So that value is equal to rho. So what we observe is that rho is equal to the correlation coefficient in between x and y. So in case of bivariate normal distribution, we got the significance of this fifth parameter rho. So this fifth parameter is actually the correlation coefficient in between x and y. So that's all for this lecture. Thank you for being with us.